Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another special movie reaction. Today, Thursday, we're going to be watching American Psycho. Now, I really love Thursdays because these are something that is outside of the Patreon polls, really, and it's something that I can kind of, like, pick aside and watch something that, A, I've either seen before or, A, I haven't seen before, and that is something called American Psycho. Now, I'm gonna make this disclaimer right here, right now, because I know a lot of you guys are probably saying, yo, how have you not seen these iconic films and yet you're a filmmaker? I have not seen these films, and I definitely would not waste my damn time going through and watching them and then lying about it. I just don't think that's just, it's just something that I just don't feel like has to be done in the first place. There are moments where obviously I do tell you that I have seen the film and I still do a video about it, but I make it very clear that I've seen the film before. Trust me, I would not lie to you guys, and I would make sure that I want to say this because I just kind of want to end it right here and there. There's no way I can either prove it to you. You're just going to have to trust me on that. So for those of you who do believe me, thank you. And for those of you who don't, I don't know what to tell you. But guys, again, like, I'm really excited to kind of like jump into this one because, again, it's a staple in filmmaking, I guess you could say. I mean, it's something that I've always wanted to watch, but I just never did. And now I'm excited to kind of bring it forth towards this YouTube channel because, again, like, I have so many of you guys and I know, like, knowledge of filmmaking itself, and now I'm able to kind of look at these films from a first viewing and kind of like not only experience it for the first time, but also look at it from a filmmaking perspective and hopefully shed some insight on certain frames or certain scenes that maybe you guys may have not picked up on your first, second, or third time watching this film. And a lot of you guys have mentioned that towards the comments, and I just want to say that that is awesome. I'm so happy that I'm able to help educate you guys, especially now more than ever. I mean, my people out there who are in college and film school, you know, I have plenty of you guys saying that this channel really does help because, you know, unfortunately, you're not really able to, you know, take advantage of the college atmosphere, especially now. So you guys tune to my channel and hopefully pick up some few things and also help me learn a few things. I mean, I think that's awesome that we're able to have a community like that. And I just want to say thank you so, so much. So I greatly appreciate you guys. And I definitely want to recommend, as always, if you want to get the full prior experience, definitely check out that Patreon link below. There we have our full events, we have early access, we have voting polls. You can recommend me movies and I'll actually be able to put it on the Patreon polls first. If that's something that you're interested in, definitely check out that Patreon link. It definitely helps out and I am super appreciative for all you guys out there. But like always, I'm going to stop talking. Let's get into this one-of-a-kind American Psycho. This is a pretty interesting intro. I actually kind of like it. I love how it was being shot and how, like, the music kind of went along with it, like a little symphony almost. It's pretty interesting. Great way to segue into your story.
Paul Allen's on the other side of the room over there.
Who's he with?
I'm Weasel from Kicker Peabody.
They don't have a good bathroom to do coke in.
Are you sure that's Paul Allen over there?
Wow. All right. I don't know why this is already giving me like a what is that show called? Mad Men?
It's the voice of reason. Boy next door. Speaking of reasonable.
Only 570.
Not bad.
Did they all just have like the same credit cards too? Like what the heck? Talk about being different, huh?
You're a fucking ugly bitch. I wanna stab you to death. And play around with your blood.
Whoa. Thankfully she didn't hear that. What the heck? That's interesting that it was shot in like a mirror too. That was bizarre.
My name is Patrick Bateman. I'm 27 years old. I believe in taking care of myself.
That's a beautiful shot. I really like that shot there.
Protective lotion. There is an idea of a Patrick Bateman. Some kind of abstraction. But there is no real me. You can shake my hand and feel flesh gripping yours, and maybe you can even sense our lifestyles are probably comparable. I simply...
He's like almost like a... like an alien or like a droid. I was wondering what this monologue would probably represent because I know he wasn't just talking just to talk. But it definitely, what I got from that, it almost showed him like a chameleon, you know, like maybe we saw hints of that when he actually, you know, was name calling that one girl at the bar.
You're prettier than that.
Thanks, Patrick.
I'm not here. And high heels. I like high heels.
Oh, dude. What the heck? Oh, dude, that was like some, that was a little toxic there, buddy. Damn.
About it.
I hate that job anyway. See why you just don't quit.
Because I want to fit in.
Wow. All right. That's most definitely a weird reason to keep a job like that. He just wants to fit in. But I guess we can attach that with kind of what he was talking about in the monologue, right?
For the homeless, and oppose racial discrimination and promote civil rights while also promoting equal rights for women. We have to encourage.
This dude, I don't know why, he just sounds like a douchebag when he says it. Like, like what he's saying is very good, but he's like almost saying it in like a mockery sort of tone. Really love this shot here, how the camera just tracked that entire scene. That was really well done, especially with the music playing in the background to create this very claustrophobic, horrific atmosphere. It's interesting that he's just casually playing like pornographic videos and not even paying attention to him. It's like he just plays them in the background.
And then to the Pottery Bar, where I got this little silver muffin dish.
Great shot right here. Great shot. It's almost as if, like, you know, you can clearly see her face, but his is, you know, absolutely blurred, kind of, you know, depicting that chameleon vibe he was kind of like talking about in his monologue.
Glasses. Marcus and I even go to the same barber, although I have a slightly better haircut.
So how's the ransom account going, Marcus?
It's all right.
Really? That's interesting. It's not a...
Oh, wow, that's Jared Leto. That took me some time to get. I don't know why. I was wondering.
New card. What do you think?
Whoa. Very nice. Look at that.
Again, it's very fascinating because, like, he's like joyfully mocking other people.
That is really super. How'd a nitwit like you get so tasteful?
I can't believe that Bryce prefers Van Patten's card to mine.
But wait.
The fact that he's getting agitated by that small little thing, you guys all have the same card, which is so interesting.
It has a watermark.
Wow.
Patrick, you're sweating.
I love how this is being brilliantly shot and portrayed. And obviously, Kristen Bell's acting is just phenomenal. But what I really, really like, you know, is just the subtle sound design in the background on those tiny moments. Because those tiny moments are not tiny when all of those things orchestrate with one another. They can make that scene, that little card scene, be so dramatic.
Cold out here. It's
what a fucking loser you are.
What the f- Yo! Oh, yo, yeah, he's- Wow, that was- It's not Batman at all. Jeez, that was beyond effed up.
Flesh, blood, skin, hair. But not a single clear, identifiable emotion. Except for greed and disgust.
That entire monologue, again, is just phenomenal. You could definitely tell it was written in a book. Because that was so beautifully descriptive.
Tell you that, Halberstram? But they don't have to kill you.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Well, he would actually kill you. That's the scary part.
Did you know I'm utterly insane?
It feels like everyone who's doing this acting is just like going to the extreme, but they're just slightly keeping it contained. So it's just a bunch of things bottled up.
New wave for my taste. But when sports came out in 83, I think they really came into their own, commercially and artistically.
Hey, you gotta read the room, homie. You gotta read the room. He's gonna kill you, dude. Like, what? He wrapped it up like he had like a black grandma. Like, are you kidding me? You gotta read that room. Yo, he's like going in and out of different personalities, dude. It's creepy.
And the importance of trends, it's also a personal statement about the band itself. Hey, Paul!
Ah! Ooh! Oh my goodness. Yo! Oh man, yo, he's a problem. He is a problem. Wow. And then just like that, he just lets it out and then just gets right back into his chameleon. His chameleon skin. That is creepy, man.
Of sheer panic when I realized that Paul's apartment overlooks the park. And it's obviously more expensive than mine.
This dude, like, he loses it when, like, I don't know, he just feels like...
Suitcase and start to pack.
He just wants people to notice him, which is absurd because he's like just killing people. But the thing that gets him like over the edge is when he's not being noticed.
This is Paul. Been called away to London for a few days. Meredith, I'll call you when I get back. Hasta la vista, baby.
Yo, what?
Made an appointment. Was that anything important?
All that? Just mulling over business problems, examining opportunities, exchanging rumors.
This scene right here almost gives me like Wolf of Wall Street vibes. When the detective is talking to Leonardo DiCaprio's character on the yacht. You guys know what I'm talking about.
School. Your address?
The American Gardens building, West 81st Street.
Nice. Very nice.
Thanks.
What can you tell me about Paul Allen?
I love that the camera is... again, just like emphasizing those smaller moments, but to him, you know that they're big. When someone compliments him in other movies, they probably wouldn't have highlighted that, but because it's in this movie, it's because it's with his character, they highlighted that. That's great use of editing. Yo. Yo, this dude seems desensitized. Because first he was doing that with pornography, and now he's doing it just with, like, murder movies. And he's not paying attention to them. He just has them in the background. Like, he's almost, like, desensitized to it. Because I know earlier he was talking about how he just doesn't feel anything anymore. And he's afraid of what's going to happen. But, like, geez, that is... I don't know. Tell me what you guys thought about that scene.
Have you heard of it?
It seems like he's trying to get his pleasure just, again, with, like, self-gratitude.
You can practically hear every nuance of every instrument. Sabrina, remove your dress. In terms of lyrical craftsmanship...
Yo, this is crazy how he's just, like, commanding them, but he's just continuing his monologue again, like... This is so wild to me. Like, wow. Christian Bale, dude, you're incredible.
That's very nice, Lewis. Thank you.
It's almost as if this society breeds people like him. You know? Because everyone is reacting similar to it. It's just that we're following his story. It almost feels like any one of these men could be him because of the society that they're in. I'm also noticing that mirrors are playing a lot in this movie.
Patrick, why here? I've seen you looking at me. I've noticed your hot body.
Oh, man.
You can't imagine how long I've wanted this ever since that Christmas.
Oh, my goodness. Oh. Wow. I wonder why that specifically almost broke him. You know? And I wonder if this is like a kind of like a conversation on like masculinity as well too.
Tonight.
Dinner at a River Cafe. Old bar afterwards, maybe.
That's nice.
Never knew you smoked.
Again, like there's just so many instances where he's looking at himself in the mirror. You know? And obviously mirrors, just in general, reflections, you know, and him being like a chameleon that he is, I mean, it's like, I think mirrors almost tell a story in itself within this. You know, what is his identity? Who is he?
And Gene, don't want to change before we go out.
Damn, dude. He's always saying, oh my God. Oh man, this is just.
Gene? Sorbet?
This dude is snapping. What the heck? And I love how the film doesn't like highlight, it just casually shows it. And I think that's what's so like horrific about this film is that like because of just how subtle some of the stuff is, and I'm just like, oh my goodness.
Say I just want to have a meaningful relationship with someone special.
What the f- Oh my goodness. Yo. Again, like how it just subtly does that. Like it doesn't emphasize it or does any like crazy, you know, standard horror tropes. I love how they just casually do that, where it just builds up this feeling of just, like, unease. Oh, man, dude, this is crazy. I love the tracking of the camera. You know, it happens in several scenes, but it is really well done. When it comes to like placing like a more horror aspect on the film.
This universal message crosses all boundaries and instills one with the hope that it's not too late.
Yo, Christian Bale is so good, dude. He is so good. He knows how to embody a character like never before. My goodness. It's such an attractive character because how much he's just able to embrace the extreme. Like, oh my goodness. Yo, what the heck? Jeez. Yeah, this is not good. Oh my goodness. Yo. Yo. You have to be kidding me. Please get the heck out of there now. I love how this is almost like a mockery of the Texas Chainsaw scene earlier in the film. Oh, snap. Yo. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, man. I don't even know how he even got out of that one previous incident. Did you see how many bodies were in that place? You mean to tell me that no one heard or seen anything of that nature.
What are you doing? Stop that.
Bro, what the freak? Dog, what is he doing? What is he doing? I think he just completely snapped. He's done.
Drop the weapon! Drop it now! Get on the ground! But
dude, this dude's having a whole... Yo, he's shooting at cops right now. He's completely over it. This almost seems like a nightmare, like... I feel like he's, like, getting his high from this.
Burning the midnight oil, Mr. Smith? Hey, now don't forget to sign in.
Oh my goodness, dog. Holy crap. I know this is like, you know, he's a psychopath, so duh, but, like, it's still just so absurd. Like, he's just killing everyone. Does he not know who he is anymore? Like, has he completely went off on the deep end and he just doesn't recognize himself anymore?
An NYU girl I met in Central Park. I left her in a parking lot behind some donut shop. I killed Bethany, my old girlfriend, with a nail gun.
What is going on? He's just completely lost control.
I ate some of their brains.
What?
And I tried to cook a little.
Yo. Oh my god. Yo. Oh my god. This film is on something else. Wow. Christian Bale is phenomenal, man. Like, he's able to portray such a broken character who's just a mass murderer as well. So good. Like, what the heck? Like, I really do wonder what's in Christian Bale's head right now to help him activate this performance.
You stupid bastard.
Jeez.
Because I had dinner with Paul Allen twice in London. Just 10 days ago.
No, you...
What? Wait, huh?
Didn't.
Now, if you'll excuse me.
What? What? Huh? So it wasn't real. Was he all just imagining it? Oh my goodness, man. That haunting music in the background with the girl singing. Oh man, it is scary. I'm not gonna lie. Reminds me of like the soundtrack from Akira during the hospital scene.
But even after admitting this, there is no catharsis. My punishment continues to elude me, and I gain no deeper knowledge of myself.
Wow, these monologues are powerful.
Nothing.
Wow. Oh my goodness, guys. And that was American Psycho. What the heck, man? All right, everybody. We just got done wrapping up American Psycho. Wow, this film. I could see why it was probably big talk when it came out. This thing is crazy. This is a crazy film. And I mean that in a good way. Like, I mean that in a good way because it wasn't just crazy just to be crazy. It was crazy in a way where it almost spoke on something deeper. And it tried to explore the madness of it. And man, Christian Bale, dude. Oh my god. Oh man. This definitely would mess up the Batman trilogy, huh? If this was like his prequel. Man, wow. Talk about a story that touched on a lot of potential deep conversations. And this is definitely I'm probably gonna have to look up an analysis or something, because I was there until the last act. Not to say that it, you know, dove in quality or anything like that. I think it actually rose in quality because I was questioning a lot more, and I was still in the unknown. But the last act really went on more of like the Shutter Island, you know, just sort of, you don't know what reality is. You're not sure what reality, you know, what's right, what's true or false. And I love that. I love that it really took the time to dive into his psyche and to almost literally put us into the front seat. Because I think during the first half of the movie, we were kind of, you know, on the outside looking in, and the conversation of like what it's like to be within, and his monologues almost guiding us to tell us like what he feels it's like to be within him, you know, literally like hearing his monologues. But I think towards the second act of the film, that's when we truly started getting like that front seat viewing within his mind, to where the filmmaking just almost, there was no direction. Like, you don't know what is left and right anymore. You're just kind of in the motion going just as insane as him. At least that was my personal experience. And man, I mean, this was a brutally gorgeous film. Very brutally gorgeous, surreal. No, like, punches were held back. I think they did a great job showcasing just the psychology of not just this character, but I think what American, I guess you could say, like, venture off into American capitalism, or, you know, toxic masculinity and the environment that kind of birthed that and how that feels. I mean, there's so many potential avenues you can kind of take that's worth discussing, you know, not to say that they're right nor wrong, but they're worth still venturing in. And I think that's great. I think there's a lot of conversation for that. So please tell me what your thoughts were on this. For those of you who do stick around to the conclusion, I would love to hear your thoughts and your breakdowns and your analysis on this type of film. I'm really excited. I'm really happy with how this turned out because this blew my expectations. So yeah, this was really awesome. Thank you guys again for like just rocking with me and everything like that. I'm still kind of flabbergasted. This is kind of crazy. But like always, guys, if you want to see the full length, I highly recommend it. Definitely check out the Patreon link. Stay healthy, stay hydrated, because we are just getting started. Purple jacket, pocket full of weed. Everything that I should ever need. Grab some matches cause they give them free. Like my time. Hair pulled back in the back seat.